Hi guys, it's Bayou with Bayou with the Twist Cooking, and welcome to the show. We have a great show lined up for you today. Today we're going to be cooking Bayou's Creole chicken and sausage pasta, but the real treat of today's show is our guest. We have guests. They are a girl group out of Houston, Texas. They do some amazing things. They're great performers. They're beautiful, great music. You're going to love them. I'd like for you to watch their videos, and when we get back, we're going to be cooking with Blush. Ladies, if you wanna keep 'em, gotta work. 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 Ladies, if you wanna keep 'em, gotta work.
Let me be your motivation. Never keep you waiting. Love you long time. Forget about temptation. Independent woman, I came to you. Be loyal, you want it. Appreciate you. Play Call of Duty. Watch a movie. Get hella groovy. I'll be faithful to your heart. You want me to work, work, work. Just do me right so I don't have to murk, murk, murk. By your side, I'll be your bunny, you fly. We work in the dance floor, you grip in my thigh.
Hi guys, welcome back. Didn't I tell you? Blush is in the house. So I want to introduce you to these beautiful ladies. I'm going to start right here to my left.
Yes.
Sonny, what's going on? How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great. You're so beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
If y'all saw that video, just amazing. And to my right, the singer of the group.
What's up, what's up, what's up? Ms. How you doing?
All right. Miss Bunny Ray. So we got some amazing things for you today. We're going to get in, we're going to talk, and you'll learn all about Blush, and you'll get to know them like I do. But before we do, we want to get started. So, ladies, how often do you cook? You like cooking?
Well, you know, we have this routine where Sonny goes and get the groceries, me and Bunny get in the kitchen and kind of go this way.
Mm-hmm.
She's much. More of the, like,
exotic.
Yeah.
This is your home, your mother's cooking.
Rice type.
Yes, it's your mother's.
So
it's
I'm
the chicken type.
Mm.
Yeah.
And I'm gravy. With you. You buy it. Y'all cook it up.
See what you need.
I'll clean. Yeah. She makes like amazing plantains. And she's half Colombian. So she makes like this Colombian soup.
I kind of feel like I have to know the spices. So. But I'm not on that
level. To cook. Well, today.
We get to learn something new today.
You sure do. Today you're going to get to try Bayou's Creole chicken and sausage pasta. Ooh. I'm a little nervous because these beautiful ladies around me. So what we're going to do is we're going to have you get started with, we're going to start sauteing vegetables. So in order to do that, we need some vegetables. If you ladies want to help us cut.
No problem.
Okay.
You start cutting. And I'm going to turn your stove on here.
Well, how small do you want?
Right. Let me give you an example.
Yeah, let's get
okay,
an example.
Okay, there we go.
You know what I suggest? You start with, put a couple tablespoons, so that's about maybe that much in there. You can use, just break it with this. No, we kind of improvise, you know?
No, you can use anything.
Bell pepper. Yeah, there you go. And just start warming it up. So what you want to do is you want to just make some really thin slices. So just take your knife and
thin
just kind of go through. Yeah,
okay.
And we'll leave them whole like this. So if you want to
okay.
Finish
okay.
That, same thing with, and we can use about half of each.
Okay, I'm going to solve for the struggle.
I've
seen it out of my
peripheral. It is. You know what? Because it's froze. I just
it's good for butter.
So, what else is there? But I'm going to grab a spoon
right
for
now.
You.
Okay.
And as, there you go, you can just start moving your butter around in the pan so that it melts. So once this butter melts, what we're going to do is put all of our veggies in, and we're going to saute those and let those get translucent. For the home chefs, that means you want to just... basically when it gets off. So while that's doing that, I'm gonna go back here. I have a pot of water that's boiling. I'm gonna put some salt in there and a little bit of oil, and I'm going to make about a pound of your favorite pasta. Because it's like an Alfredo.
Mm-hmm. Like Alfredo, yes.
Yeah. I love Cajun food and Creole, so you get it.
So then you'll love this because it's full of vegetables, which is healthy for you, and I'm trying to stay healthy.
We all are.
Right, we all.
And then y'all superstars, which we're going to get into so you have to be healthy. But it tastes good. It's got a lot of flavor in it and some really good ingredients and an Alfredo sauce that you're going to make from scratch.
Ooh,
no more jar stuff. Don't buy
no
it.
Jars.
Make your own. It's easy. So we'll get the pasta started.
Okay,
but
now.
While you ladies are working on that, tell me, who wants to start? What is it like being Blush?
What is it like being Blush?
Hmm.
It's fun.
It's fun, yeah.
It's fun. fun. It's a journey.
It is a journey.
How long have you guys been on this journey?
Wow. Well, we've been, we're signed to Mr. Matthew Knows. We have been under him now for almost 3 years. We did actually 2 years of artist development. So this is really our first year with our foot in the door in the industry. It's been amazing thus far. A little background. We were, you know, already a group. Mr. Knows didn't create us. So shout out to social media because we all came from social media.
Sonny found me on Facebook. Yes. We found her on Instagram.
Instagram. Ooh, don't point your knife at home at anyone.
No. Yeah, you don't cut nobody in the kitchen. Okay, maybe I'm not a music group or anything, but I would think Matthew knows, like, to have his direction and his been under his wing, and he's created the most successful work of all time. Like, do you think that's a lot of pressure? Like, is it amazing? Like,
oh, it's like a goal. It's really like that trophy that's at the top because you're like, dang, he did it before with them. Mm-hmm. It kind of makes us like push harder. Mm-hmm. It's low-key like, well, they did it. We're going to be the number one female hip-hop trio.
Yeah. Right.
And then it helps that also he put us through the same artist development as Destiny's Child, which a lot of people don't know. Mm-hmm. We went through that course of artist development for 2 years. And it was, you know, really awesome.
Right in here.
Yes.
I'm wondering if
my husband really sounds
like you know, you're cooking right there. But, I'm all into the story.
Y'all know this. You know, butter and bell peppers could smell so good, but I don't know.
It's such a
make
fresh
you just
want to
get a fork and start eating hot.
Yeah.
I can put yours in there. It's funny.
Oh,
right?
Okay. Hey, now I got to get the slide down. You got to
always say, your plate is coming for you.
Wait a minute. That was
so great. How about conversation? You start with the break.
Yes, definitely.
Ooh, it's funny. How about you do it like this? Let's go.
Let's see.
Let's cut it in half. And then we'll just do half moves.
So, same thing.
Gotcha.
It's a little hard. There you go.
Yeah, cut hard. I think it's hard.
Hey.
Yeah, so, if you don't know, follow them on Instagram, Officially Blush. Mm-hmm. Officially Blush. They do a lot of great things in the city. And I even saw you guys at
Sheila Jackson.
Sheila Jackson.
Yeah, Sheila Jackson.
What was that about?
Yes.
Well, it actually started with us, what, we did like one event with her?
Yes.
This was like a year.
This was a while ago, yes. You had the opportunity to do an event with her. And ever since then.
We've been her girl.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Like, we're actually going to parade, Martin Luther King parade. Mm-hmm. And a lot more things that she's pulling us in. She loves us. And
I gotta tell you, I watched the video.
Toys for Kids.
Mm-hmm.
Event. That was a good Christmas.
Yeah.
That was in the drop top.
Yeah.
You know, Houston. I mean, right. Like, y'all brought me back to Houston in the 90s and with your sound and work. Who writes y'all songs? Do you write your songs?
We do.
We write. What?
Yes.
Let's get it all from the desk of love.
But check them out. Amazing.
We heard some notes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, my onion.
Oh, good. They all pretty.
Yeah. Like rainbow.
Like most vegetables I've ever cooked have been cut in my life.
So restaurant stuff. You know what, Sonny? How about you drop that pasta in the water for uplifting tonight? Drop that pasta. The whole thing, just dump it on over in that boiling water.
Pot.
Yep.
Dump it in the water.
Now, while that's doing that bunny rag, I got something else special for you to do. For this pasta, I told you guys that it was chicken and sausage. So what I did, we have some regular smoked sausage. Get a good quality. I don't like that real greasy quality smoked sausage. You'll know the difference because you see how it's kind of dried out. It's not really oily. Mm-hmm. You don't want that. I don't think it's not good. So, but let's just chop this up, make some cubes. And then yesterday for dinner, I actually roasted the chicken. I like to roast whole chickens because we don't ever eat all of it, but you can always use it for the next day. You can make chicken salad out of it. You can make sandwiches. You can do whatever you want. So today we're going to take that roasted chicken, and you can see I roasted it with onions inside of it and some lemons and put it in the oven. So, but this is the white meat because I like the dark meat. So we have the breasts and all those meats. I've deboned it. So what you're going to do is just cut this. Cube it up, and we're going to use that for our meat.
This is like a vegetable humidifier in my face right now.
Really?
Awesome. All right.
A vegetable humidifier.
You know, y'all, it smells so amazing.
It does.
I got another super task for you.
Yes.
So our Creole seasoning, right?
Mm-hmm. Creole.
Do you use Creole seasoning?
Yes.
Okay.
We got Tony's.
Yeah, there you go. But I'm going to show you how to make your own. This is basically what that is. So get your bowl here.
Okay.
That Creole seasoning.
Pay attention, Sonny, so we can bring this home with us.
I am paying attention.
So, Y'all didn't see that. Okay. I'm going to hand you this, and then there is a thing. So we're going to, that's salt.
Okay, that's
so
salt.
So we're going to put about a tablespoon of each. Mm-hmm. You have garlic powder. You may have to.
Yeah. Make sure I get my full tablespoon.
Yeah, get a full tablespoon, and you can just put it in there.
I have a nicer, I need more sharper knife.
Oh, you want some real food.
Yeah, you know, I'm trying to do this one.
Perfect. Tablespoon of salt.
Thank you.
Know the recipe already. That's what I'm talking about. Black pepper.
Black pepper.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, I think I measured that one out. You could just
dump I think so too.
And then look, we have some crushed red pepper flakes. Mm-hmm. Use my scarf. Same amount about those. Now, that's the little extra kick.
That's the olive like that. Mm-hmm.
Crushed red pepper flakes make everything taste good. You don't need a lot of it. That's a lot of it. You don't need a lot of it. Because a little bit goes a long way, but it really adds the spice to your food, but it doesn't make it salty. Mm. I don't like salty food.
I don't either. I like flavor.
So do I put this in?
That was cayenne pepper. So Miss Sunny over here is about to really burn us up today. We're going to be
grilled. You said a tablespoon of each.
I'm sorry. That's okay. Because what we're going to do, we have that cream. We have a lot of flavors here, so it'll
improvise.
Yes.
We took a little that that was actually,
what did I say to his world?
Cayenne pepper. Mm-hmm. Everybody know cayenne pepper.
You guys make a little mistake in the kitchen. All you got to do is
put it in.
All right.
Improvise.
There you go. And let's give her a couple tablespoons of that garlic. This is just regular minced garlic. So basically what we're doing is we're frying all of our meat. If our chicken wasn't done, and if they were, because you can just take chicken breast straight out of the refrigerator, right? And chop them up. If you like meat and like dark meat, you can take the chicken thighs, the boneless chicken thighs, and just cube that up.
The garlic, I'm sorry.
It all is not good.
It does. It's like opening my nostrils right
now. I'm in the best seat in the house, you guys.
You are. Right. And the steam is like setting the makeup and everything. It's like
multiple things. Setting
the makeup. Yes.
Humidifying.
Sometimes you need the extra set.
This is perfect.
She in a whole other world right now. But, what was it?
That. You was talking about if we like dark meat like that.
Oh yeah, okay. Yes. So the chicken breast. So basically, you would do the same process, like you put the sausage in, and you would cook it together until your chicken is done.
Right.
So since the chicken's already done, the salt is smoked. We're gonna just basically let these onions be
transferred. But the thing about this sausage is, I know it's not as greasy, and that's a plus because I have a hernia, hiatal hernia, and I can't have those type of things. So I'm already pushing with the spice, but.
I haven't been able to really have sausage, but
I think I'm
going to be able to. A really good quality smoked sausage. There you go.
Yeah.
Now, take this pork and just mix it up, and then after that, we're going to put some, chop up those mushrooms. That's about a pound or so of mushrooms. I'm a really big cook on our fan of vegetables. Mm-hmm. I think that they're really important to stay strong and healthy.
Mm-hmm. True.
So,
not fake veggies.
I'm doing wonderful. Actually, I need that on every show. Yeah. I just stand back and direct and look cute. And then
we just have this like little puppet. You can tell us what to do.
Just tell us what to do.
We got you.
We're good with instructions.
And relax your feet.
All right. You said
party on down to the...
Hey.
Just kicking.
Got chicken. Yeah.
Okay, in the kitchen, jamming with blush. Amazing. So what you ladies have coming up?
Ooh. Great, because we're excited because we're getting ready to get in the studio and give the people some new music, release the music, an album.
Yes.
Wow. Traveling, obviously in a city near you, we're going to be hitting stages, festivals.
We'll be in LA next month as well, doing champion cupcakes.
Champagne and cupcakes.
That sounds good. My two favorite things, sweet and... If you like cupcakes, then you're going to love the treat we got later on. But I ain't going to say too much about that.
I eat my dessert before I eat my meal.
These are facts.
Exactly. One of the things I love about blush, if you are, I'm class of 2000, so I'm from that era of the 90s music. That music is popular again. And these ladies are just like, they embody it, like their music. just bring me back to when you was in high school, skipping school on lunch break to go to McDonald's.
Don't skip school.
Don't do that. I'm just saying. If
he's
you want to
go to McDonald's.
Chicken, just so that I'm
clear.
Just call me.
Same thing.
Yeah.
Gotcha. And that you don't have to put in a bowl because actually what we're going to do is, I'm going to grab that platter and we're going to dump this over because actually these veggies look pretty good. I want to show you how to make that Alfredo sauce.
Ooh. So we're dumping this?
We're dumping that. You may want to grab one of those spoons and check your pasta. Just give it a stir because I'm still balling over a little bit. I see what you're talking about. This smells so amazing.
Yes.
I'm so sad I didn't let it go.
But I'll be back.
Okay, you'll get to eat it. Amazing.
So
we'll just sit that out of the way. What you want to do is start with your butter. When you're making a roux, any type of roux that you make, you'll start with equal parts oil and flour. You put the whole thing in. So that's about 2 or 3 tablespoons. So we'll do about 2 or 3 tablespoons of flour. I'll just put that in for you.
2 or 3 tablespoons of flour. And you're going for 3?
I'm going for 3. There you go. So let me talk to you about roux, though, real quick. If you make a gravy, a roux is to start, in Louisiana, a roux is to start up pretty much every dish. Gumbo, you make a roux. Etouffee, you make a roux. Gravy, smothered, whatever, you make a roux. What gives it the different flavors is how long you cook it and how dark you let it get. So today we're making Alfredo, which is a white cream sauce. So, of course, we're not going to cook our roux.
As long. Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
See what I'm saying over here? Hey. Learning. Okay. So,
pop quiz.
Right. How long you cook your roux? So what we're gonna do is basically cook the flour. Mm-hmm. Okay. And once it starts to get thick and white, we're gonna grab that heavy cream over there.
All right.
So you can grab that heavy cream.
Okay.
Over there.
That's
and then when you do it, we're gonna do about 1.5 cups because we put 3 tablespoons. And once we put that heavy cream in, we'll let it cook. The roux is actually a thickening agent. Use it for thickening. So it'll make the cream a little thick and we're going to add the seasoning. It's just great. And then we'll put the meat in and let everything cook together. And then once the pasta gets done, we'll toss it up and then serve it.
Ooh.
Oh, one more thing though. I have some French bread now.
Oh, my favorite. It's my weakness.
Guys, I'm all about store-bought stuff and getting help along. I like to make my dishes, you know. Mm-hmm. Store-bought French bread, can't go wrong. They got it buttered already. It's got the little parsley on there. Like, it smells good.
It does.
How about you pop that in the oven for us? Because that's going to take about 10 minutes to toast up.
Okay.
And
see, I feel like we can do this at home, you guys. We just cook this way.
So right. You're making the process probably like,
you know, I'm going to put this on a little pretty card for you guys so you can have it. But I'm so sorry, but her stove wouldn't even own y'all.
You know, because everybody put it on 375 for everything.
Yeah.
Everything at 375.
I just hit start.
Everything.
So,
can't go
we
wrong.
Got our stove on now. I'm gonna move this out the way.
All
and
right.
You could actually slice these mushrooms up. And look, this is how we're going to do these. You like mushrooms?
I do.
I like them cooked in my food.
Yeah.
For the vegans out there, you can completely omit the meat from this dish. Mm-hmm. Like, but if you do, I would recommend using like a portobello mushroom. You know, they're really big and they're hearty. They thick. They give you that full feeling. Like,
right.
That's my whole thing about meat. I'm gonna just pass you and kind of clean up here.
Chicken. Where do you want it to go?
You can put it back in the bowl.
Back in the bowl? Okay.
Yeah, until we're ready for it.
And the beginning roux is...
How are we looking over there?
It is bubbling. It is cooking. It is mixing.
Now, see, this is the color that you want. It's cooking because you don't want to taste raw flour, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if you were to do like a gravy, then you would just keep cooking this roux and let it get darker. A gumbo, you just put it in the thing on. Mm-hmm. But I usually get a little store-bought help. I like kitchen bouquet.
Okay?
It's a little yellow thing. Like,
I think I've seen it.
Add it to your roux. It gives it the color that you want. But we're not making that kind of gravy today. We're just making Alfredo.
Okay, now.
So while you're doing that, I'm going to go ahead and get the cream. I know about 1.5 cups. Actually,
it's
some brush work quality stuff.
Nice.
I found my.
Got too happy, too quick.
I did.
She back.
I'm back.
Back and better. That's amazing. So I really hope you guys cook this dish.
No, we really are. We're going to definitely see you, and we're probably going to live you, and
right.
we're going to do a little bit of FaceTime you,
there you go.
So that we can go to step by step again.
Okay.
To be.
And you can substitute, you can put shrimp in this if you like.
Ooh, I'm sure. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I see there's some onions in here. Would
I'm
you
gonna
like
use that too.
Okay, yeah. So just leave them as they are. Mm-hmm.
Okay, gotcha. Cut all the mushrooms, correct?
Yep. So this is a cup. We'll put about a half cup.
Make sure I got all the whole pieces out.
If you don't have half and half, you can know. It's not good.
So if you don't have half and half, use the milk.
What about almond milk? I know, almond milk, I know, because you know I use almond because I'm lactose intolerant. Oh, okay, so yeah, if you try it you let me know. All right, so we're going along real good here. We have our chicken that's nice and diced up, our roux, see how thick it's. Yeah, it smells good. It's looking like it's good.
Mm-hmm.
Like I got my room.
Hey, hold on.
On a plate, you might need two. Bunny got the chicken too.
Chop, chop, chop.
But don't forget your mushroom.
Yeah. freestyle a little bit on y'all.
We had a pasta on the floor, but that's what we want to do is start assembling this.
So let's grab that plate. Right. We're going to put that back in.
Okay, awesome.
You can dump your chicken in.
Okay, go ahead.
You dump your mushrooms in.
Let me make sure this is all separated.
I got the
orange.
Look at
the wrist.
Look at her wrist. Yeah. This smells really good. Like, bring it in. Bring it in.
Bring it on in.
I get why you said, am I ready to stir all this?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Need the muscles, girl.
Control. I'm so glad you're here because I would really want to be stirring that and had it all over my wife. We're all seasoning we mixed up.
Did you check those bowls right there?
Awesome.
There you go. I have to find it.
Let's put our.
There we go.
Seasoning on in there.
It's all you need. It's all you need.
Yes. What we're gonna do? I'm gonna just chop up some. Let me grab this. So I'm gonna just chop up some green onions. And these are going to be used as our cornish.
Yes, to the onions, the cut messy like you.
Okay. Okay. See, the knife wasn't working for me, but it's working for him.
It's the way you do it. You got the flick of the wrist music. So we have our green onions, and I'm going to just take a lemon.
Yes, to the fresh squeeze.
Now, what taste does the lemon give to the pasta?
Great question. Lemon, first of all, lemon go great with seafood. But lemon, it's got that sour taste, but lemon makes all flavors pop. So in this dish, we're just going to squeeze some in there. And you won't actually taste lemonade, but you know, it'll just make everything.
It's like a highlight. When you put it with the blush.
Okay. I see what you did.
Love it.
Our pastas.
Miss Sunny is back there grabbing our pasta.
Get it, sunshine.
Because I couldn't find the strainer, we're going to use this. I'm going to hold it. And you pour. We just want the water to
break. Okay, everybody don't have the right cooking utensils.
We don't have the right stuff.
And if you didn't have it, just use the top. Look at a towel and hold the pot.
Yeah, come on.
Okay.
Come on, muscles
and noodles.
Look at noodles.
There you go. All we're going to do is put this pasta. Actually, I don't think I.
Wait. That was really good. Oh, you know what?
I'm missing one thing. No, you're great over here. Okay. I'm sorry. I'm talking about us.
It's okay.
Miss Bunny Ray, somewhere up in here, we got some chicken stock.
Some chicken stock?
Can you find that for me? Do you see that?
I'm hunting for the chicken stock.
Yeah, that's the hunt.
There it is.
Noodles. Now the chicken stock.
I spy with my eye.
Excellent.
There you go.
Organic so, chicken stock. Let me tell you something about chicken stock. Normally, look, I don't buy this stuff. What I do, because I can tell you, I always cook whole chickens. Whole chickens are cheaper, and you can usually get like a really good organic whole chicken, and you cook it, and you can use it for different things. But the bone, like if I fry it, the bones of it, like if you carve it, I'm not teaching you how to carve a chicken. Yeah. But if you carve it before you cook it, and you freeze those bones, then on a day like today or Saturday when you're not doing anything, you can boil those bones with some onions and all these peppers we have here, and you make your own stock. And then you just put it in a container, and then you use it so that you don't have to pay $4 or $5 for this farm stuff. Which is still good.
Yeah.
But you make your own and you control what's in it. Mm-hmm. I'm just adding, this is about maybe half a cup. I'm adding this so that it will break up and give us a little bit more juicy or Alfredo, because we have a lot of pasta here to cook. So look pretty.
Yeah.
You're hungry because...
I'm hungry.
Let's see it.
We like to eat.
Yeah.
We like food.
Mm-hmm.
It's that southern twang.
Actually, you know what? Let's kind of straighten up. We're going to put all this here so that we can start as you ready.
Straighten up as you go.
The magic of television. Our crew, who's back here, and they will help me clean all this That's such an awesome group. I'm going to move this out the way because what we want to do is we're going to mix this up in this pot.
All right.
So, you ready to use the muscle?
Here you go.
So, this is going in here.
Yes.
Yes.
All right, let's do this.
We are blending.
Hey.
Oh, it smells amazing.
You know, when it looks this good, it kind of just don't matter how you put it in there, as long as you get it in there.
Exactly. This is the type of food I like to give me a big bowl of and just curl in front of the TV.
And indulge.
Watch I can Tino.
Fine.
Yes.
You know, because I gives me like
this grip. I got
this grip though? Chef Curry with the pot, boy.
I'm going to move our portable stove out the way. And I'm going to grab a serving dish here.
Pasta. Yep.
It's okay, because, you know.
Let's see. I'm going to help you out here with this big reveal. Y'all ready? Let's see what this looks like.
Make it do what it do.
The Cosby hands.
There you go. I'm just stirring.
Yes. Imagine serving that at your dinner party. Your guests will be amazing. Then what you just want to do is just top that with your green onions that you cut.
Voila.
You better cut it. You know what I'm saying? Maybe put you wild lemons in. Let's put that in there.
Cooked vegetable in the mix.
And then just for garnish, that's just in case anybody else, when you serve it. Mm-hmm. Tough little lemon here. If your lemons are tough, no, here's a tip though, for real. If your lemons are tough or your limes and you want to put them in lemonade or water, pop them in the microwave for about 3 seconds.
Oh,
they
wow.
will make the juices get all juicy or whatever. So let's just serve that up like that. And that's amazing. If you want to grab some plates right there, we can taste it. Let's plate it up.
Let's plate it up.
All this so how people at home can get a really great shot of.
And I'm
going to
push this like that so I can see our beautiful dish.
Man, this looks amazing.
Don't this look amazing?
Oh, goddess. Okay.
So excited. This is the best part, you guys.
This is actually, we actually cook here.
Okay, a napkin for you.
Thank you.
Man, I ain't gonna lie, I couldn't wait to eat this.
It's just so pretty. Can y'all see this?
I feel like I'm supposed to take a...
Just pitch yourself in.
Mama, we could. I know, it should be proud of.
It's visible.
Me and these vegetables.
Let's give this a try.
Right.
Let's try that sausage first. I'm gonna smoke sausage.
That sausage is good.
That is so amazing. And the seasoning from cooking the chicken yesterday, add extra seasoning. Amazing.
And I don't even care about all these vegetables that I don't eat.
I ate it.
I'm with you, Sonny, on that one.
It is really good.
So I'm not a veggie lover, but I will eat some veggies if, like, when they cook comes right together. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I feel like it's supposed to go with
that
bread.
Matters.
Okay. Now, I hope that you guys have room for dessert, because I have one last treat for you.
I'm ready.
I'm going to move this out of the way.
Okay. The bread.
Because I want to do the
I haven't gotten to the bread yet. Wait.
You have to get to the bread.
Okay. Get my bread.
Wait a minute.
Get your bread on.
Yeah.
Everybody did it at the same time.
That one was from the soul.
Giant commercial.
What I have to reveal to you guys is really amazing. So I have this really great friend. She has a bakery here in Houston. She heard you guys were coming. And she made a treat for you.
Blush like
sweets. Blush like treats.
That is it.
I'm going to just grab it real quick.
Y'all already blessed us with these aprons.
I know. God,
you're so fabulous. Great. You're fabulous.
This is from Queens of Cakes and Things.
Oh my God.
The ladies of Queens of Cakes and Things. This is real.
It has sparkle.
That is the most beautiful cake
I ever had. I want you guys to see, but I need them to see this front. Isn't that pretty?
That is so pretty. We're a cake.
Yes! This is the first time anyone's ever done this for us. That's so
sweet. Thank you. We're cake. Man, we've had such amazing time here with Mr. Craig on the Bayou with a Twist on HLTV. It's been a pleasure. We need y'all to go check us out, officiallyblush.com. Mm-hmm. Go check out those videos. It's been an amazing time. I'm Sunny.
I'm Tally.
I'm Bunny Ray.
And we are Blush.
We're going to enjoy some cake and finish it in the school. Thank you for watching. We love you. Bayou with a Twist again. Peace and love.